Chrissy Lucas, and I am a groundwater protection education program assistant for the OSU Extension Service. Well, coliform is it's basically a family of bacteria that only exists on the surface. So it's found on pretty much every surface around you. Definitely the soil, trees, anything that you touch probably has coliform on it. In fecal coliform is E. coli 0157, which is what most people are familiar with, but any of the fecal coliform family are not things that we want to be drinking. If you find coliform present in your well water sample, that's telling you that there is surface to groundwater interaction. The only way that you would know if your well has coliform or fecal coliform is to actually get a well test done at an accredited laboratory, because you can't see, taste, or smell coliform bacteria in your water. So to test your well, there are some at-home tests that you can get for coliform. They're not super accurate always. You have to be very careful in the way you're handling the test because, like I said before, coliform is everywhere. You really want to have a test that's very accurate. You want to use a private accredited laboratory. So if your well comes back positive for coliform, the first thing is to not drink the water. Go out and try and figure out what could be the potential contaminant source. Go out and kind of do a property evaluation and see if you can figure out where that coliform could potentially be coming from. You'll want to do some sort of treatment. So in the short term, if you can figure out where that coliform is coming from, you're going to want to resolve that issue and then treat your well. Treatment typically would be shock chlorination for a one-time quick remedy. Shock chlorination is where you actually use a chlorine bleach. Make sure if you're using chlorine bleach that you only use the unscented variety, not the scented kind. And you're actually going to put that chlorine bleach directly into your well, and it will actually disperse into the water, the aquifer that your well is pulling from, and will kill the coliform bacteria. It is really important to note that if your well contains arsenic in any way, shape, or form, not to shock chlorinate your well, to try and come up with a different treatment option, because shock chlorinating your well will actually increase the level of arsenic that is available in the aquifer. If in the long run, this happens over and over and over and coliform keeps coming back positive and you've found and fixed everything that you can think of on your property, then it's time to move forward with a longer term solution. So bottled water really isn't a solution at this point because you aren't going to be wanting to wash your clothes, take a shower with coliform contaminated water. So you can get treatment like an ozone treater. There's a UV light, and then there's also a continual chlorination unit that you can get, and then you would follow that one up with a charcoal filter to remove that chlorine.